Καλησπέρα σας, καλοί φίλοι τηλεθεατές. Good evening to you. Καλώς ορίσατε στην εκπομπή μας Faces, πρόσωπα. Ένα πρόσωπο που ίσως, είμαι σίγουρος, πολλοί από εσάς να το γνωρίζετε ή μπορεί και να ακούτε τη φωνή της από το ραδιόφωνο, από το ελληνικό ραδιόφωνο του Λονδίνου, τον LGR. Είναι η Κατερίνα Νεοκλέους. Καλησπέρα, Κατερίνα.
Καλησπέρα, Βασίλη.
Welcome to Hellenic TV.
Thank you for having me.
I'm happy to have you here. Θέλει να μιλήσουμε στα ελληνικά ή στα αγγλικά?
Αγγλικά, I think.
Αγγλικά, you prefer English, yes?
With the odd Greek.
Okay, you can, yeah, you can turn to English and Greek anytime you like. It's not a problem. Welcome anyway. I'm very happy to have you here because actually we see each other very often,
yeah.
Because you come into HGR and you're doing your program, especially Fridays, when I mean, you finish and I take over.
That's right, yeah. And you pop into the show sometimes.
Yes, and I pop in and I talk to you about various things. And you're doing your Tuesday night show.
That's right.
As well, 8 o'clock.
8 scandalous. Till 10 p.m., that's right, scandalous. Yes, yes. All the latest Greek tunes.
Yes. Good. This is about LGR. We're going to talk about it later on,
okay.
As well as, you know, we can explain what exactly you do in the program and... you have interviews on this kind of thing, you tell us later on.
Okay.
But at the moment, I like traveling, you know what I mean? But not forwards, backwards.
Right, time traveling then.
The time traveling. Can we go back to not far away, to London, North London,
right?
Where you born?
That's right. Well, actually, I was born in East London.
Oh my God. I get it wrong. Hey, never mind.
But I've lived...
East London, but how long have you lived there?
I've lived most of my life in North London.
In North London,
yeah.
Yes. Your parents are Cypriots.
That's right, both. From Aradipu.
Aradipu village.
In Larnaca,
yes.
That's right.
Από το χωριό Αραδίπου, μεγαλώνει Αραδίπου. It's a big village at the moment,
yeah.
Yes?
You can't really call it a village anymore.
No, it's a necomopolis, you know.
Yeah.
It's a town. Anyway, but you born in East London...
Mm-hmm.
You did the school there, or?
No, I think I was probably only there for maybe a year.
Ah, yeah.
Before
then,
my mum and dad moved over to North London, yeah.
And your dad and mum, they were in business, still are? Or?
They're retired now.
Ah, retired.
They came over when the war happened in 74, and they were running a fish shop. So, very,
for,
yeah.
A long time, yes?
For a long time, yeah.
Oh my God, you say fish shop and I just missed the fish and chips.
I do too.
Yeah. Anyway, how many members in the family?
Five of us.
Five?
Yeah, and I'm the baby.
How many girls and how many boys?
Three girls, two boys.
And you are a baby?
I am.
Oh my God.
Yeah. The only one born in London.
Did you have your milk today?
My milk today, maybe tonight.
Okay, so your father and mother are from Aradipu, retired now. You did your school days in North London,
yeah.
And then you study where?
I went on to study, university. I went to Westminster University, where I did commercial music.
And then you went into performing arts.
Yeah, so that was strictly singer-songwriting, performance with my singing.
In university, yes.
And okay. Then later on I went to do my acting diploma.
Yes.
Which was straight acting. So I've done a variety of
Why
things.
You decided to go into this, studies? I mean, to study music and all this, you know?
What do you mean when it began?
Why? What makes you? I mean, do you have anybody from the family involved in it? Your father, mother, papus, yeah. From Aradipu, there are so many singers and musicians.
Yeah, we're lucky. There's quite a few successful singers.
What was the reason?
In terms of my family, not musicians as such, but music was always in the house.
How old were you when you say to yourself, I like to become a musician, to be a singer, to be a performing artist?
I think I always loved it from when I was little. I started off probably with acting first.
Yes.
So I was in all the school plays, and that's initially why I thought I was going to go with performing. I was really shy growing up, so it came more easily. And then I guess when I got to my teens, I got a bit braver and I started singing and... Yeah, I guess it was just, I enjoyed it. It was a way for me to be creative and really come out of myself, I think.
Nobody else from the family involved in this business?
No, not professionally, no.
Just you, yes.
Yeah.
Just you. When you mean not professionally, is your father, for example, or mother singing, or your brothers?
Well, my mum used to sing around the house, and, as I said, we always had music on.
In the kitchen, yes.
And we'd go
Cucina.
To...
When she was cooking, she was singing as
well. Yeah, she was cooking, or while they were working, LGR was on.
Ο λόγος που τραγούδαν η μάμα σου, τώρα που μαγείρευαν, που τηγάνιζαν, κατσάριζαν το... Δεν την ακούγαν κανένας, φαίνεται. Anyway, so, now, you did... You know, I mean, you are involved in this business professionally, mm-hmm. and you did quite a few things. Can you tell us a couple of things you are you've been involved in? You think they help you to?
I think in terms of
singing for example,
in terms of the singing, I started as well as writing my own songs and doing gigs with that. I sang in a lot of function bands. Sort of at the beginning of my professional career, which was it was great. It means I had to learn a lot of songs, was different audiences. I was singing Greek and English, so that's kind of where I started. Mm-hmm. And from then, I wanted to do more of my own stuff, write my own songs, and start gigging with my own material. Mm-hmm. So that's how that is.
I remember some time ago you wrote a song for BBC. What was that about?
Oh yeah, I did. I worked with Crocodile Music, and I worked on two commissions for the BBC. It was to write theme songs for the Rick Stein cookery program.
Oh, that's good.
And one song was in Greek when they did a Mediterranean series. Yes.
And you wrote the theme of the program.
Yeah, so I wrote the theme.
That's good.
The theme, and it was on the soundtrack. Yeah, so it was a really great experience. It was one definitely. Of my first songs I wrote in Greek as well.
Did that open other doors? And, you get other offers and all this?
It did. I ended up working with them again later when I sent my song to Eurovision.
Ah.
So they helped me put that song together, record it.
That was a Eurovision Song Contest, the songs that they took part in a final.
Yeah, it was...
To choose the song for the Eurovision,
One of my songs made it to be a finalist for the national final.
Was it a good experience?
Yeah, it was good. It was good. I got to do a little radio tour. I got to perform... on a big stage, everything like that. So yeah, it was a great experience.
Yes. How about acting? I mean, have you done any acting?
Well, acting, I've done a few things. I've done most of my experience is theatre that I've done, but I did a short film last year.
Oh,
I got to go up to York, which I hadn't been before. Really lovely.
Historical. You filmed it there, yes.
Yeah, it was filmed in York. And so that was one of my first tastes, I guess, of like a full... sort of how it all works and everything like that. And it was a really, again, a great experience and something I'd love to do more of.
They did the film for festivals?
They're hoping to submit it for festivals.
They haven't sent it yet?
No, I think it's still...
Still working on it?
Yeah, still working on it.
Uh-huh. Okay. So, any other acting experience?
I've done... I was in... Your play, wasn't I?
I thought I remember.
Is that what you were fishing for?
I thought
for?
I remember you from somewhere.
That's right, yeah. God, that was a couple of years
that
ago.
That was a different experience, I suppose, because it was in Greek, yeah?
Yeah, it was in Greek. And
Proxenia.
It was the Proxenia.
Arranged marriage.
That's right.
Yes.
And it was a comedy.
Comedy,
which up until that point, I'd done a lot of serious...
Yes.
sort of theatre roles, some of the classics and things like that. So that was really good fun to do something.
Did you enjoy that?
I did enjoy it, it was good fun.
It was an experience, it was good, yes.
It was good, so, it was...
All right, how you find it? I mean, I suppose, okay, you're born here, you have the... that your first language is English, obviously, and all this, but did you find it easy? I mean... When you call for auditions and they hear your name is Katerina Neocleous, what do they do? What do they say?
Well, sometimes there's like curiosity. I always get asked, where's it from and everything. And some people have said, about changing my name. But I've always refuse to change my name. I like my name. I like that it sounds Cypriot.
Yeah.
I'm very proud of my roots. So yeah, so it's always quite an interesting conversation opener.
If it was something like Kat Neo, for example, it would have been, you know, foreign name. What do you think?
Yeah, that's been suggested a few times. Yes. So yeah, you know, maybe I could abbreviate it.
Try it. You know what I mean? You never know. So do you play any instruments?
I've started drum lessons.
Ah.
Yeah, so I play the drums.
How do you find it? Is it?
I love it.
Yes.
I really do. I'm really enjoying it. Whenever if I'd have a band practice, I'd always have a little go. And I just figured, well, why not learn professionally? I'm a big believer in always learning and adding to your skill set. So, yeah, why not?
Okay. Any gigs? I mean, you took part in gigs and all this kind of thing. Any charity shows you're doing or whatever?
Yeah, I've done quite a few. I'm hoping definitely this year to get some regular gigs going. I've got a few sort of small intimate venues, so I can go and I can try out my new music and you know, see how it goes. So that's kind of part of my big plan this year, to do lots more gigs, and you know, if they're charity gigs, even better.
Mm-hmm. What your parents think about you becoming a performer, I mean, entertainer, actor, and you know, singer, all these kind of things.
I'm really lucky because my mum and dad are so supportive.
Yes.
And they're always really interested in what I'm doing. You know, if my mum, if she hears a song that she thinks is great, she'll call me up and she'll be like, oh, you should learn this song. You know, and both my mum and dad are really, you know, they're my champions. They really believe in me and want me to do well, so I couldn't ask for.
They support you. Yes.
Yeah, I'm very
lucky.
That's
a good idea. That's good. Okay, that's fine. I like actually to see something, to show something which you might be, you know, I mean, have. So our audience see what exactly you do and all this kind of thing, which is a show reel.
Right.
Okay. Can we go and see it? And
yes, let's have a look.
Okay. It's
thank you.
Kat Neocleous, is it Kat Neocleous?
Yes.
Kat Neocleous, a showreel, samples of your work, yes?
Yes.
Okay, let's go and see it.
Matt, I don't want to be with you anymore.
What?
I don't think this is what I want.
I asked you to marry me 2 weeks ago.
I made a mistake.
Well, you made a mistake saying yes.
Yes.
Hey.
Still in your pyjamas? That's a productive day.
I deserve it.
So what's new?
Thomas isn't texting me back. The Prime Minister used the C word on Twitter by mistake. There's been a plane crash.
What? No way.
Yeah, over Norway.
Are you joking? Is that meant to be a joke?
No, it's all over the news.
My sister flew from Norway today.
I thought I'd make us a nice lasagna.
Oh, cheese.
Yeah, that also does have cheese.
No.
It does.
Yeah, I know, but I mean, you can't. Well, you can, but I can't eat it. I'm intolerant.
That's one word for it.
No, I mean, I'm intolerant to dairy.
I thought your thing was gluten.
That too.
Right, so you don't eat dairy or gluten?
The food I eat is super. I eat superfoods, in fact.
Look, I know work's been stressing you out recently.
It's not about work.
Don't do this now. This is one of those moments where
I'm not happy. What was the airline?
I don't know.
Jen, what was it? Where's the TV thing?
Just chill out, I'm getting on the phone. It was some Swedish airline.
She flew Sweden. Are there any? It's Mum. Hi, Mum. How's...
Brilliant. So that's Kat Neocleous. Okay. Do you have an agent?
Yes, I do.
You do, yes.
I'm signed to F&I Associates.
Yeah. Was it difficult to find them? How you managed to get them?
Well, I did a 7-month musical theatre course, sort of the tail end of 2016 and last year.
Uh-huh.
It was 7 months intensive. And at the end of that, we had a showcase. So we got to show
and
sort of...
they invite all the...
Yeah, so you invite all the agents and everything like that. And yeah, so they came along and they saw it and then they offered me representation.
Since when? Since when? Last year?
A couple of months now, yeah.
A couple of months ago.
Yeah.
And now, have they sent you to any auditions yet?
Yeah, so they submit me for theatre, for musicals, and for TV and film as well. So, so yeah.
Did
so
you get anything yet?
I'm waiting to hear back on some stuff, so fingers crossed.
Yes, yeah. Oh, yes. I wish you the best.
Thank
you. Okay, now, what would you prefer? I mean, would you like to do straight acting? Would you like to do a musical theatre? You want to do plays, serious plays and all this kind of thing? What is your preference?
I think my heart belongs to theatre.
Belongs to theatre.
First and foremost. Because I love it that you have that journey within the play, and
you create another character.
Yeah,
and you live another life.
Inhibit it and inhabit it, and I love all the research that goes into it, and when you're preparing for the character, and that every night, you know, it can be a different experience. That aim to make it fresh every time. Mm-hmm. So, I think that's where my heart lies.
That's good. That's good, and. Singing, I mean, you have anything coming up soon?
So the last few months I've been concentrating on writing. So something I want to definitely get on with this year is to get in the studio and actually bring them to life. Because I've had lots of songs there, they're sitting there, I go and I gig with the songs. Mm-hmm. But I think I've wanted to put an album together for so long, so that's really one of my priorities this year. To get the songs recorded in an album, so yeah.
Ah.
So that's what I'm hoping to do this year.
Your plan is to have your own album, yes?
Yes.
That's good. Okay, do you have any recorded songs yet? I mean, you have plenty, I suppose.
For the ones that I want to put for this collection...
Not yet.
Because there's a couple that I've written a while ago, but I think most of them, I want them to be the new material that
new material, I've worked on. Something to do with new ideas, new people and this kind of thing?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay, you prefer ballads or...
Oh.
Exactly.
I think, I do like a good ballad, but I also... I like something you can move to as well, so hopefully there'll be a little bit of everything on the album.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, because we didn't have any chance to, listen to your voice yet. Is it possible to just give us an example of your voice? A
little sing-song.
Yes, please.
What would you like me to sing? Something English?
Anything. Greek? How about Greek?
A little
something
bit of Greek.
Greek.
Should we pull out a little classic? Let's have a think. Okay. I'll sing a little bit of Το Φεγγάρι.
Φεγγάρι is good, yes.
Τα πιο όπως το φεγγάρι, okay.
Τα πιο...
That's the one. Τα πιο απόψε το φεγγάρι και θα μεθύσω και θα μπω αφού πονάς για κάποια άλλη, ρίξε μαχαίρι να κοπώ. Και όταν με κόψει το μαχαίρι, μετανιωμένος θα μου πεις φεγγάριου το δάκρυ από το αίμα να πληθείς μπάρε του φεγγάριου το δάκρυ από το αίμα να πληθείς.
Bravo. Bravo, Hellenic.
Thank you, Vasily.
Yeah, your voice is very well trained.
Thank you.
Yes, bravo, bravo. Είναι πολύ δύσκολο τραγούδι αυτό. Τα καταφέρνει μια χαρά. Μπράβο, συγχαρητήρια.
Thank you.
Last Wednesday, you were doing a gig somewhere, yes?
Yes.
Tell us about
it. So it's at a small little intimate venue that I, of my first time performing there, mm-hmm. Called My Time, and in Palmer's Green.
My Time?
My Time, it's
not
called.
Not very far from here, yes?
Not very far at all.
Yes.
Around the corner from me.
Okay.
And I really enjoy doing local events, I have to say. It's really lovely being part of the community,
yes, yes,
and the
yes.
Cypriot community is right there,
yes,
as well. So
that's
to
good.
Share
yes.
my songs and do some of my favourite covers.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, it's always good fun.
How long was the show?
Half an hour set.
Half an hour.
So
that's
I did a little
good.
Half an hour set.
Lovely.
And I hope to
Beautiful.
Sing there again soon.
Do you know when the next one is going to be?
I don't know, but hopefully soon.
Let me know.
I will let you
let
know.
Let us know, please, yes.
Yes,
we'd
definitely.
Like to come. We'd like to come, okay? Any other future plans?
Future plans? Wow. Well, I'm hoping I would like to go back to LA.
Oh.
To do, I last year.
You went there last year.
I went there last year.
Okay.
To do some method acting training.
Uh-huh.
And with some amazing teachers.
Yes.
Who worked with Lee Strasberg.
Uh-huh.
So I went there last year, and I'd really love to go again and do some more training
good.
With them. And yeah, so that's something I'd like to add in this year if I manage it.
Beautiful. Are you, είσαι το κορίτσι της μαμάς και του μπαμπά, δηλαδή επειδή μέσα σε αυτές τις business, you're, I suppose you are too busy, you know, practicing all this kind of thing, μαγειρεύουν για σένα ή μαγειρεύεις εσύ ή τι?
I do cook. Mum and Dad are in Cyprus.
Are they at the
yeah,
moment?
Yeah, they're in Cyprus at the moment.
Ah,
so I have
to
fend
Cyprus.
For myself. But I'm very lucky because my brother.
They stay there or they go back or
They're staying there. They're staying
ah,
there, yeah.
Okay.
So,
you,
so yeah,
you're cooking?
I have to cook for myself.
Ah.
But I'm very lucky. My brothers and sisters, they make sure that I'm well fed as well. So
yeah.
I won't
Is
go
it
hungry.
Greek cuisine? Greek cuisine?
Yeah, we do lots of Greek
yeah,
dishes
that's
as well.
Macaronia do furno and all this kind of
my,
thing.
One of my favorites.
Pupepia. Κολοκάζει,
κιοφτέρε,
ναι, ναι, ναι. Μπράβο, μπράβο. Any hobbies?
Hobbies, wow.
You play anything? I mean, sports or whatever?
Sports, why do you know?
You read, you go to cinema?
Oh, well, yeah, definitely. Anything to do with film and TV. Love going to the cinema. I like sports too. I haven't done it for a while. I probably should
get
back on that. I used to, when I was young, I used to play football.
If you play football, I tell you what, I have an offer for you, because Hellenic TV is going to, we're organizing a seven by side.
Oh,
you
right.
know, yes,
seven aside,
what you call it, seven aside. From the one side, it's going to be the women.
Right.
It's the first time. The other side, the men. Okay?
Okay.
So, if you want to play against the men,
yeah,
you can be in the team. You know, the Hellenic TV team, okay?
Sounds quite good, yeah.
Yeah,
maybe I might
good,
take you up
yes.
on that.
Yeah, it's quite good. So, yes, I'll let you know. Okay, how about LGR? I mean, give us more information about your
LGR.
Programs. I mean, you're doing a program every Friday, 10 to 12,
mm-hmm,
which is
morning.
A musical program only, or you do...
I guess it's predominantly a music program,
yes.
and a little bit of chit-chat as well.
Chit-chat, yes.
You know,
But
yeah,
you're doing more on Tuesday night.
On Tuesday nights, yeah, for Scandalous, I'll do a little bit of the gossip, celebrity news,
uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. Play all the very latest songs.
Mm-hmm.
So it's more focused on the newest songs
yes.
on Scandalous. Friday is a little bit more varied. I'll,
yes.
I'll go back to some of the sort of
uh-huh.
older.
And you
like
do because I can see your picture every Thursday on in the newspaper. Parigyagi, you have your own column.
Yeah, I've got a music column, entertainment column
yes.
in the Parigyagi, which is, again, it's another way to you know, keep with the community. And I love
mm-hmm.
I love including any events, local events that are going on, or interview mm-hmm. other singer-songwriters or anything uh-huh. like that. I love to put that in the column because, yeah, to let everyone know what's going on. And to help promote ourselves as well,
yes.
to promote other singers in the community, other actors, and really champion the talent in our
mm-hmm.
our community.
Well, what about you know your new album?
Mm-hmm.
You say it's new material and all this kind of thing.
Yeah.
Where you get the ideas from? I mean, what subjects you gonna use?
I guess the first port of call is my own experiences. Uh-huh. So a lot of the songs come from moments in my life, you know, the highs and the lows. But also I get inspiration from maybe watching a film. Uh-huh. And something might move me or or spark an idea, or even like a painting or an article. Mm-hmm. One of my songs is called Violet Eyes, and it's about domestic violence. Uh-huh. Thankfully, I've never experienced that, but I read an article about a lady who had, and it really spoke to me, and I wanted to... I think music is so powerful. Yes. I wanted to... honor that experience through a song. So, yeah, I think you can find inspiration everywhere.
Yes. How about the lows and the highs? Can you give us an example of your high times?
High times?
Yes.
Generally, or how it
generally
is in my...
Generally, in life, you know what I mean, yes.
The fact that I can pursue my dream is a huge high for me. Because it is so difficult, it's a difficult industry. So for me, that makes me happy every day that I can really pursue it. Lows, I guess, like anything, it's the loss of someone or whatever, you know, facing your fears and things like that, which for anyone is a challenge. Yeah. And so I try to incorporate that in my music as well.
Is there something in your mind which is going to stay there and bother you all the time? About lows and, you know, low time in your life?
I think, yeah, for sure. I think it does, but I try to be as positive. Yeah. You know, it's not always easy, of course.
Just close the door and, you know.
Yeah, I don't find it easy to close the door. But what I try to do is channel it through my music or find ways to find the silver lining in anything, you know. And I think music is a really great way to do that, as is any kind of art, or to have that kind of outlet, you know, it's it's really helpful and cathartic. Mm.
What is the most important thing for a young, you know, girl like you, for example, to do to be able to succeed and fulfill their dreams?
I think you just have to keep going. I think if it's something you really want to do, you just have to find that resilience, because there is a lot of closed doors initially, you know, sometimes. And there'll be people that will tell you that you can't do it or to, you know, give up. But you have to just
believe in yourself.
I think that is a huge thing. And it's, again, not the easiest thing sometimes when there's lots of no's and things like that. But I think it... is finding that fire within you to keep you going. And in the end, if you believe it and you want it enough, I do believe that you can achieve it.
You can achieve it, yes. Good, good, good. Okay. Do you have any website or a contact, you know, number or anything, if someone wants to get in touch with you about your column in Barigagi or about your program in LGR or whatever?
Or you can
it might be directors might be watching and they want to cast you?
Well, if it's to do with getting in touch with me or finding out more about my music, then I'm on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter as Kat Neocleous, or you can also find me at katsmusic.com. In terms of acting, if there are any directors would like to offer me a starring role, you can contact my agent at F&I Associates.
Beautiful.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much for being here with me tonight, and I wish you all the best.
Thank you.
With everything you do, like with the radio, with the newspaper, with your acting, your singing, and when you have your new album ready, let me know so we can, promote it for you as well. What else can I say? I wish you all the best.
Thank you. Thanks so much. Thank you.
Thank you. And I like to say a big thank you to our sponsors, Mr. Βασίλης Μαύρος, Dr. Βασίλης Μαύρος, Βαροσιλέτινγκς. Thank you very much. Ευχαριστούμε πάρα πολύ για την χορηγία. Να είστε καλά. Και να ευχηθούμε να έχετε καλές δουλειές πάντα. Να ευχαριστήσω και εσάς, τους καλούς φίλους τηλεθεατές που είναι μαζί μας. Και να σας ευχηθώ να έχετε μια θαυμάσια εβδομάδα. Εγώ και εσείς θα είμαστε μαζί και την ερχόμενη Κυριακή, την ίδια ώρα, με ένα καινούργιο πρόσωπο ή πρόσωπα. Μέχρι τότε, να προσέχετε τους εαυτούς σας, να παρακολουθάτε και να ακούτε και το LGR κάθε Παρασκευή στις 10 με 12, πριν, λίγο πριν το μεσημέρι, με την Κατερίνα Νεοκλέους, και κάθε Τρίτη να την ακούτε στις 8 με 10 στην εκπομπή Σκάνδαλος. Okay. Κατερίνα, μου σου ευχαριστώ.
Thank
να είσαι καλά.
So much,
have a good night.
Thank you.
Αυτά, καλοί φίλοι, φιλοθεατές. Πολύ αγάπη. Καληνύχτα σας.